Hey guys, here we are again in Abyssrealm or Tap Tap Fish or whatever this game is called. I never can figure this out. I always say Abyssrealm just because it was called Abyssrealm when I started playing it ages ago. I've been playing a couple of days now since last time, and when you play every single day, you earn more gems every day. I think I'm gonna call them gems now. So I have earned up a bunch of tickets as well. So I can get a bunch of different event fish. So I think we should are gonna like have a look and see what we can do today. I also know that I have an achievement to pick up. Let's just set this skill ongoing so our little Coralite will get working on gaining that vitality. So let's see here on achievements. I have taken a lot of pictures because I've been trying different things out. So I'm gonna grab the rewards. And I can grab two rewards. So I'm gonna get so many gems. I've been playing the game for 9 days now. And I've been watching 30 videos. So loads of gems for me. Nothing here I can pick up yet. Did I pick this up? Yes, I did. So one thing I would like to do is to level up my Coralite. And I'm not entirely sure if I will have vitality enough to do so. Because I think when we reach level 300 that the Coralite will expand a bit. And also we will unlock a new skill. So I'm gonna try and see if that actually happens. Oh yeah, it's 25 levels more. So, oops. So now we have the vitality production multiplier. And the Coralite did not expand. I guess it will expand when I reach level 500 then. But I'm gonna pick this new skill, click the heart, and get a lot of vitality. I think. I'm not entirely sure how that particular skill works. I just know it gains or will give me a lot of vitality. So now I'm going to take a photo of the whale to get a lot of vitality. And then let's... Oh yeah, we're gonna have a look at the coral, because I have unlocked a new coral, or two new corals. So first I'm gonna get the bonus from some other corals. I've been like saving them, just to make sure that you guys will see what I have done with them. The corals have expanded a bit since last time, because I have been continuing to grow them. But I decided to wait up here to ensure that you guys will be able to keep up with what I'm doing. So we're gonna just take all of these rewards. And we're going to get our first starfish. It's gonna show up here, I think. Yep. And we're gonna produce our first white anemone, which shows up down here. And that's good because it helps us gain more vitality. And I think I should also buy some seaweed because that will help us to create more fish, which we can merge with each other to get like entirely new types of fish. So I'm going to purchase this. And that will show up over here. So we continue to expand our Coralite. And now we can create pink skunk clownfish and Wyoming white clownfish. So as you can see, things are growing. We're going to do another couple of things. I want to buy the Mystic Shell artifact. Unfortunately, I can't. I do have enough gems, but I don't have the right level for my Coralite. I need to level up. I forgot about that. I thought I would be able to buy that now. I'm not. Typical, of course. Can we buy a fish? We can. And I have unlocked a bunch of new fishes. As you can see here, I unlock gobies by having 5 clownfish and fresh seaweed. And also, if I go down a bit, I do have a sea slug somewhere here. I want a sea slug. I haven't bought it yet. Let's see exactly where it is. Here. So when you've been playing the game for 7 days, you will get the sea slug. So I'm going to buy one because I think they're fun to have around. And it's kind of cute, I guess. I don't know. Look at it. So yeah, it's going to be around here for now. So that was yet another fish. We're gonna have a look at the achievements. We can get more, 10 more gems. And if we look here, we have tapped fish vitality 500 times, which gives me 50 more gems. Perfect. You also see here that the game center thing from Google is going crazy. I'm not entirely sure how that works because I usually play this on an iPhone. As I have mentioned previously, when I'm playing this on a computer, I play it through a software called BlueStacks. So I am playing on a computer right now. I'm not playing this on a phone. And I do prefer playing this game on a phone. This is one of the few games I like playing on phones. But I think it works perfectly fine on a computer for me to be able to show you guys most of it. And also, I think this is kind of fun. I think it's a relaxing and fun game series to have. So I'll probably just release an episode every now and then because it's easy for me to make and I think it's fun and relaxing. Let's do something here. I should probably get more vitality by watching ads, but I won't do that while you guys are here, of course. Because I don't want to just throw ads in your faces. I don't think that's nice. But let's go for the event instead. I'm gonna do like this. I'm going to head into the die section. And I have bought the circus stage, so I'm just going to open it up. So now when I have this, I can collect event tickets from my fish to earn up enough to fill up the meter here with the crab. And when I have done so, the crab will start earning event tickets for me every second for a short period of time. So I just want to fill his meter up so he can start earning some tickets for me and we can start buying some fish. And the event fish does not work as the regular fish, but I think they are fun to collect. Even though, as I've said previously, I'm not super fond of the events in this game because I'm kind of tired of them. But I did try this event out on my phone just to see what it was like, and I realized that it could be kind of fun to try it out here anyway. And as you can see, we have a lot of tickets, so we can get started quite quickly. I'm going to buy 5 Jester Idols in order to be able to buy the Circus Trainee Sea Pig. And you can buy them with gems as well. I don't want to, because we will be perfectly fine using only the event tickets. So for now, let's buy 5 Jester Idols. I need 3 more. It would be nice if you could, like, pick how many you want to buy from the get-go. But, I mean, this game isn't really made to do that. I think the game is more made for you to earn things as you go. Now I've been saving up for quite a while just to be able to do this quickly. Was that 4? That was 4. And also when you buy several fish of the same species, they will go like in bigger groups together, which is very nice to look at. One of my favorite events was I think it was called like Starry Night or something a couple of years ago, when you had like the fish kind of looked like star signs. It was like stars which made up an entire fish. And they were so gorgeous to have around in your aquarium. So I really hope that that event will return, because I would just fill my entire reef up with those. Love them. So now I'm gonna get, I think I'm gonna get 5 of these as well. But maybe I'm gonna start with the circus pig. Well, this sea pig, I don't know what this is. And since they all are in costume as well, I have no idea what they would be called in real life. So, whatever. I just think they're fun to have here. And sometimes you do unlock some achievements by doing all these events. So for now, I'm just gonna do that. And while I wasn't very keen on doing the events when I started playing this series, I have changed my mind and think, like, it's kind of fun to be able to collect them all. And I would probably buy one of each if I could. I don't think I can, but anyway. And why do I buy 5 of everything? Well, mostly because if I buy 5 of some species, I will unlock more species. And also, they are very cute when you are together. So we're gonna have one more. And I think we might unlock another fish by doing this. I'm not entirely sure. No. So let's see here. We have the Jester clownfish. So if we have 5 clownfish, we will unlock the parade band Nautilus. But we won't have enough event tickets for that. But we'll get one of these cowfish at least. Yep. And now we're down to just 200 event tickets. I'm not entirely sure what this actually is, to be fair. But I will. Oh yeah, here's some sort of extra quests for the parade. I have done this on my phone. To be able to get a gift from the leader crab, you just like disturb it by clicking it. So I'm gonna click it a lot. I don't really know how to do this, but sooner or later it's gonna like, here you go. It's gonna have this cloudy thing and give you a gift. And when you've done that 10 times, I think you can only do so many times a day. Not sure what the limit is. When you have 10 of these, you will have completed that special quest. I'm just gonna continue to disturb it as much as I can. And we got a gem, that's nice. Thank you, crab. And also, as you can see in here, I get 2 event tickets every time it blobs. If I watch this video, I will get 200 tickets. I have already upgraded my hermit crab once. For 600 event tickets, I can upgrade him again, and then I would get more tickets for every single like little blob thingy. So yeah, that's it. Can we do more here? Soon we'll be able to get some seaweed. I'm gonna take a photo of the clownfish to get some more vitality. And let's see here. And also, of course, if I don't want to have the circus around anymore, I can just go into the this section and just change a different dye of the reef, and then this will be gone. And well, I can pick whatever I want to have. So for now, I think we should. Can I buy more fish? I can. So let's go up here again and see. I want another goby. Yay! Look at this little pretty one. It's good. We can have another one. Oh, nice. Let's just pick another one right away. Perfect. I don't think we can afford another one. Can we? Yes, we can. Nice. So now when I do have the vitality to it, I'm just going to get as many fish as I can. Because it's going to help me later anyway. It's going to help the vitality production. Now I can... Later. Now I can pick up some more seaweed up there. Do you have any achievements here? Or was it just an achievement outside of the game? Outside of the game, apparently. Now I can't get more fish for now. I don't think I want more coral. See, no. And I can't do much here either. As you can see. I can always use the recharge skill just by watching an ad to get access to my skills quicker. But as you know, I don't want to watch ads while playing this with you guys. So while I'm not recording, I do watch a lot of ads because I'll have this game running in the background a lot while I'm doing other things on my PC. Just because I think it's nice and relaxing, and I think it's very nice to look at. I do enjoy this game. Like, it's not a fun game, but it's still something that I think it's nice to have, basically. There we go. Now the vitality production is up a bit. gonna continue to get some tickets. I don't think you can get the gifts from the crab while he's giving you tickets. I've been trying to rouse him to give me a gift, but I haven't really been able to figure out how to. But oh well. Doesn't really matter anyway. I can wait. But one thing that I'm really looking forward to is when my coralite reaches level 1500, because then I can unlock the freshwater coral. And I couldn't really remember what that was, so I checked in on my phone where I have been playing this game before. And it is basically a coral that looks a lot like this one, but with only freshwater fish. And the game doesn't really work on my phone right now because I have so many fish, so it's a bit too laggy. My phone is very old, so unfortunately it doesn't run well on my phone. But I'm really looking forward to do this again here on... well, on this kind of account. Because I think that my computer would be able to handle the game better than my phone can. And hopefully I will be able to play more. But I think that's all I had for now, actually. I don't think I have more to share. I'm just probably gonna have to watch a lot of ads and try to earn up some more event tickets and see if I can try to earn enough vitality to go close to level 500. Because at level 500, our reef will expand. We will have another really, really good skill. We can add some more things like the Mystic Shell around here. At the base of our reef to make it even more productive. And yeah, I think that's it. That is it. And thank you all for watching today. I really enjoy making these videos. I'm not sure if you enjoy watching them, but I really enjoy making them, and that's probably what counts because I am the video maker. As long as I'm having fun, that's an important thing. I think that's important for everyone who's starting out with YouTube. Just do things that you like, and that's the most important thing because you're the one creating the content. If you like this video, please like the video and give me a comment to tell me if you want to see more. And if you don't like it, well, you can tell me that too. That's okay. So that's all for today, and I really hope to see you all next time.